Before Comethazine would drop tracks like Bands, Hero, and Walk, which now has over 22 million views on YouTube and is also one of the most hilarious videos I've seen all year. Before he would collab with Rich the Kid, DJ Mustard, Ugly God, and Lil Yachty. Before he would garner close to 1 million followers on Instagram and become one of the most requested artists here on Before They Were Famous.
You stuck in your body, so you gotta enjoy your life.
Comethazine grew up in one of the toughest neighborhoods in America and witnessed some things that would shape who he is today, including one incident that changed his life forever. He began rapping as a hobby but fell in love with making music, and that passion led him to a record deal and millions of fans. And while his rise has been relatively quick, he told Lyrical Lemonade that it wasn't until he spent 40k on his neck, 25k on his wrist, and 14k on his feet that he actually felt like a rapper.
I'm a rapper though, for real.
But he does love to rock Skechers, so maybe he really is just your average dude.
Bro, I only like Skechers because niggas hated them, bro.
Good morning, afternoon, or evening, depending on when you're watching this. My name is Jeremy Hecht, AKA Lil Michael, here for you today on Before They Were Famous, taking you through the life and career of Comethazine. I know what you're probably thinking. Damn, Jay, your neck is looking real icy right now. Did you spend 50K on it? It's a new year, you're getting that YouTube money now? Well, no, I got this chain for 20 bones at a farmer's market, so if it is real gold, then I made quite the bargain. And now that you're looking at my shirt, you probably also are noticing the wrinkles in it. Couldn't find my secret. Anyways, you guys have been blowing up the comments asking for this one, and I'm a man of the people, so I couldn't leave you hanging. We've covered other newcomers like Blueface and YNW Melly, so be sure to check those out after you finish watching this video. And without any more talk, let's get into it.
Hey, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell. Boom!
Comethazine grew up Frankie Jahmier Childress on July 6, 1998, but he would later change his last name to Velazquez, inspired by the famous Spanish Golden Age painter, Diego Velazquez. Comethazine was not only inspired by his work, but like he told me, he died from a fever on some real legendary shit. And nobody else has that last name with that exact spelling. He grew up in East St. Louis, which was recently named the most dangerous city in America. According to Fox News, the list is based on incidents of violent crimes per 100,000 residents. So, understandably, he tried his best to avoid spending time in his neighborhood.
You can always travel to the good areas, you feel me?
But St. Louis didn't influence his music very much at all. In fact, he says he wanted to be the opposite of what people from his hometown were like. He says that people from St. Louis just hate on each other and no one supports. So he knew he needed to get the heck out of there. Comethazine picked up rapping not because of a passion for it at first, but because he was just bored. He never liked going out and needed something to do while chilling at his crib, so he started spit. One year for Christmas, he got a MacBook, and then he bought a microphone. He told XXL, a microphone was $200 and anybody could do that shit. So I was like, yeah. His mom hated that he was rapping and would have preferred to see him go to law school, which only motivated him to get better.
And I just wanted to do some shit she hated and get good at it. And I got good at it.
But law school was probably not an option because Comas says he could barely get a C in high school and had a lot of trouble paying attention. He had to drop out in the 10th grade after getting 4 Fs and 2 Ds during his 9th grade year. In high school, people used to call him cocaine because, well,
he's always like light skin as f***.
But later on, he started to drink a lot of lean and says he just combined Promethazine into his already existing nickname of cocaine. And that's how you have
Comethazine, you feel me? Clever as f***.
After dropping out, Comethazine attended night school. During that time, he says he would sleep all day, go to school from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m., and then work on his music after class from 9 until sunup. He did that every night for 2 straight years, perfecting his craft. At first, he says his raps were actually more on the lyrical side, using complex bar structures and metaphors. But after seeing no results, well, he took a different road. I actually used to write. I flowed on some Joey Badass type shit. That wasn't going nowhere for me, so I was like, let me do some ignorant stuff, see if that works. Musically, he's influenced by a wide range of artists, from Chief Keef to Nipsey Hussle, Jim Jones, Early Shy Glizzy, Big Mike, Lil Jojo, Waka Flocka, Eminem, 50 Cent, XXXTentacion in terms of how he used SoundCloud to his advantage, and Rick James.
Rick James was just a saucy ass nigga, you feel me?
he was so focused on music that he ended up skipping classes and almost failing night school. If it weren't for one professor in particular, he might not have graduated. His professor went out of his way to help Comethazine get his diploma, and the stakes were high, because if he didn't graduate, his mom threatened to kick him out onto the streets. Comethazine continued to make music after high school. His best friend since diapers and a man who he calls his brother named Philip was one of his biggest influences. The two made music together and always told each other that when one of them blew up, they would form a group together and be like Ray Schremer. The two never put out any music together, but they would push each other to be better, and Comethazine says that Philip is the reason we have Comethazine today. Comethazine released the EP Aloe Vera on iTunes in August of 2016, but wasn't too pleased with it looking back at the work.
You think it was horrible? I was listening to it today, I actually didn't think it was bad.
Cometh and Philip kept posting music to their individual SoundClouds, and some of Comethazine's work started gaining online buzz. With songs like Hella Chopper's remix blowing up, the song now has close to 2.5 million streams. Unfortunately, his SoundCloud was eventually shut down because he was using unoriginal beats that he didn't own. He was pretty devastated and needed a new place to release his work. That's when the YouTube channel Elevator hit him up and said he could start posting on their channel. He released his song Might Cop a Jag on Elevator, and that's what really started to blow up, to the point that labels started calling. The video now has over 3.5 million views. He followed that up with songs like Dweeb, On My Neck, and Deathwish. His songs are short, most of them not being much longer than the 2-minute mark, and he drops some pretty comedic lyrics over hard trap beats. He apparently loves doing things to piss off his mom, because he got his first tattoo on a day when his mom was already mad at him. He got a graveyard with wings that says, "There better be a studio in heaven." He was only 17 when he got it, but the tattoo shop saw his artist profile on Google and didn't question his age. He got his SoundCloud back, and his music also started to blow up there, with songs like Piped Up with 6.3 million plays, and Bands, which has a crazy 19 million streams. Even though the song Bands ended up becoming one of his biggest hits, at first,
I didn't even think it was good, bro. I hated the song, bro. I hated it. Thought it was garbage. Thought it was trash.
His music was bubbling, but it was one day in particular when he was 18 years old that would change Comethazine's life forever. While in the backseat of Philip's car driving around, his best friend was fatally shot. Losing a best friend is something I can't even comprehend. But to make things worse, Philip had a baby the week before he died. It affected Comethazine so much that he deleted his SoundCloud and decided to stop making music. It was supposed to be him and Philip doing it together, but without his other musical half, he felt lost. But life went on. After graduating from night school, he got a job in the mall at Sbarro's Pizza making $8.25 an hour, and he was even pretty good telling Double XL, "I can do all that flippy shit with the pizza dough." But eventually, he got fired. Then he got a job as a mechanic where he was a lube tech, which isn't what it sounds like.
A lube tech, basically, you just change oils and shit. Like, you do everything, like, I can't really explain it, bro.
He was making better money as a mechanic than flipping pizzas, upping his salary to $12 an hour, and said he didn't hate the job. He enjoyed fixing cars and saw it as a task similar to solving a puzzle. Plus, he says he would sell weed to all of the old white guys who came into the shop. Not a bad benefit. But the job only lasted a week because while he was at work, smoking a cigarette and working on a car, he got a call from Joey at Alamo Records in New York. And from there,
and I just left. Left my job, quit.
Comethazine still had a flashlight that he had borrowed from his manager, and his manager asked for it back. But
you didn't have to try to beat around the bush about a flashlight, bro. I hope you see this shit too. It's my flashlight now, nigga.
He says he occasionally misses the job, but wouldn't trade it for being a rapper. And
if my tour bus ever break down, I'm fixing my own shit.
Completely understand there. He decided to continue his rap dream in honor of his late friend Philip. We spoke over text and he told me that he has written verses to commemorate his brother, but hasn't released them yet. He did send me one of the bars though, and I told him I would try my best to do it justice. RIP Phil, that should get me every time. He was lit when he got hit, he was already in the sky. They were smoking in the car before the incident, so Phil was already in the clouds before he died. Rest in peace, and I know his memory will live on through Comethazine's music. In November of 2017, he signed a record deal with Alamo. It might not be all of it Alamo though, because he recently posted My Label The Ops to his IG story, saying that he might start his own label, Bawskee Records. Speaking of, on August 24th, he released the long-awaited Bawskee mixtape, which included 18 tracks.
Bawskee is like a lifestyle, bro. Like, if you do some tight shit, you just say Bawskee shit, you feel me? If you hit like a tray flip, say Bawskee shit.
Although his fans loved it, not everyone was a fan of the tape. Someone from Pitchfork wrote, "The rapper's joyless debut is the sound of a scam artist. It is unoriginal, outdated, and one of the most stylistically unappealing projects to come from the SoundCloud scene." I don't think any writer will be slowing down his movement anytime soon. He even has the made-up word-turned-lifestyle bawskee tatted on his arm. One of his most notable songs from the project is also his most romantic song. In a stunning love ballad, Comethazine professes his deepest desires to a strong, independent woman within the music industry, with lyrics like, "Take off your top, take off your socks, I know you're not a slut, bitch, I know you're not a thought," and, I'm not gonna read those lyrics out loud.
What would I do for Demi if she was here now?
I'd buy her
a bagel with cream cheese.
On the track, he lets the whole world know that he would do anything for a shot at a lifelong love with Demi Lovato.
And tell her how I feel, bro. Man, take her in the room and fuck the shit out of her.
On September 21st, 2018, he released the song Walk with the accompanying video on Lyrical Lemonade directed by Cole Bennett in what could be in contention for Video of the Year. In the video, he's rapping outrageous lyrics around an all-white suburban family who shows no reaction. In the future, he wants to do more than just music, though. He wants to do TV appearances, fashion, and succeed in all of the industries that he tries out. As for what's next, by the time you watch this, the follow-up to his bawskee project will probably already be out. And well, I hope he meets the love of his life, Demi Lovato, and they go on to live in a big house and have kids together. If he keeps up the same pace, he might even be a double XL freshman this year, and I think he could continue to grow in this game if he plays his cards right. But as for the rest of his story, well, you know it, because this is Before They Were Famous. Thank you guys for watching. My name is Jeremy Hecht. As always, please let me know in the comments down below who we should cover next for this channel. Dream good, live better, and I hope you have one hecht of a day.